You unmute and we'll open up your line. Mark, when you're ready, some thoughts on tonight's game.
The guys did our club, our city, extremely proud. I thought for 70 minutes we held our own. We played the football we wanted to play. Maybe could have created been a little bit more progressive in the final third. But then Torres, you make mistakes against teams of this level and you get punished. And ultimately that's what happened. So it's a hard one to take right now, to be honest, but just extremely proud of the guys and what they've achieved in reaching this final.
Chris Tavares, Fox 40.
Chris Tavares, Fox 40. Mark, you mentioned that you liked the way you played for the first 70 minutes, but it seemed like 75 to 80, it all just kind of came apart. What happened during that five-minute stretch?
We made a couple of errors, and when you play against world-class players, Torres is going to the World Cup in November. I think Orlando paid $9 million for him. That's more than the value of our club. You know, when you make mistakes like that, they punish you. That's the level they play at. And we don't have that level in our league. You can make mistakes and you can get away with those things, but you make mistakes at this level and you get punished, and that's what happened tonight.
Andrew Hobner,
CBS News, Sacramento. Mark, this is a club that the city really wrapped its arms around through the entirety of this run. It's a city that embraces the underdog role very much. How do you feel that the club represented the city all the way through this run up until the end?
Yeah, like I said, I think the guys made the city proud, made everyone associated with the club proud, everyone associated with the city of Sacramento proud. And I think this run has ignited a flame in the city and got the supporters behind the club, got the city buzzing about the club again after obviously a dark cloud was over it for a little bit.
To the gentleman in the back on the riser.
Thank you. How are you, coach? I know it's a tough loss. This is Alonso Contreras for Aries Pro Network. I would like to ask about Foster. He was the most dangerous player in your team, also causing a lot of danger plays on the Orlando City defensive. But I would like to ask you, what were you subbing? It was based on an injury that he suffered minutes before, or something tactically?
Yeah, he was struggling. I was really happy with Malik tonight. I thought he was a threat for us. I thought he got in behind Carlos quite a few times with a little bit of a rub of the green. Maybe he would, you know, could have gone through. Malik was fantastic, but he was tired at the end there and couldn't give any more, and that's the reason why we brought him off the field.
Gentleman in the front row.
Thank you. Mark, you were doing a solid job defensively in the first half. I'm just wondering, what was the message in the locker room at halftime? What was the plan moving forward, knowing that you were 45 minutes away, lock it down, something could happen, go your way, and then you'll be able to get the win?
Yeah, no, I thought we were very solid defensively, but we wanted to get a few numbers higher. A few numbers higher because in the first half we got a few balls into dangerous areas wide but didn't have the numbers in the box to really execute any of the crosses. So we wanted to continue being solid defensively but get our attacking midfielders a little bit higher up the park so the distance to the box isn't as long.
Before we add Sarah Hodges, Rover, come on up. We'll have you join the press conference. Captain midfielder Rodrigo Lopez tonight. Rover, we'll give you a minute to say a couple thoughts of tonight's match.
Cool.
Yeah, when you're ready.
I don't have many words right now, but just extremely proud of the team that I had the privilege of walking out tonight. We didn't hold anything back. I thought we were solid for 70, 75 minutes, and you know, we give up a goal and the tides change, but you know, I have nothing bad to say about my teammates, coaching staff, everyone involved in this organization, the fans. I think you saw it on the field. We left it all out there. It wasn't enough, but the guys tried really hard.
Sarah Hodges.
Coach, yesterday you had told me that there's no other team in the world that you'd rather be coaching. What was your message to them in the locker room?
To be proud of what they've done, to be proud of what they achieved, and to keep their heads held high, because this is only the beginning for this group. This is the first year this team's been together. It's the first year this group of players have been together. So they need to hold their heads extremely high and puff their chests out and be proud of what they've done and understand that we can achieve things if we keep this group together and keep the right mentality.
To the first row.
Rodrigo, quiero preguntarte, ¿qué dice un capitán después de una final como esta en un vestuario? Lo vimos a Luis Felipe llorando en la cancha. ¿Qué dice un capitán después de una derrota como esta?
Yo no dije nada porque habló muy bien el profe. Nos dijo que teníamos que salir con la cabeza arriba, con el pecho bien afuera y estar orgullosos de nosotros. Hemos hecho una campaña, un torneo extraordinario, y no se le puede reprochar a nadie en el equipo nada. Lo dejamos todo en la cancha. Ellos acertaron en los errores y son dignos campeones, ¿no? No pasa, ya pasó, y tenemos todavía el campeonato de liga por la cual vamos a pelear, y con la misma ilusión de quedar campeones.
The gentleman in the back in the green.
Andres with CONCACAF. You guys did an amazing run. What did it mean to almost have to be qualified in the Champions League?
Not a lot right now, to be honest. You know, it's nearly making it is not making it, you know. So, like I say, proud of the guys and proud of what they've achieved to put themselves in a position to qualify for the CONCACAF Champions League. That's an amazing feat in itself. But right now, just disappointed that we couldn't get over the line.
In the fourth row.
Yeah, Chris Boyle representing the Sacramento Bee. How much defensively did the complexion change when they subbed Michelle on compared to what Cara was offering?
Yeah, he gave them a different perspective, right? He gave them pace in behind, and he started running the channels very well, which then in turn stretched our team. But to be honest, the momentum of the game at that point, we were in complete control, I felt. But we made a mistake and we got punished, and that's just a simple fact. At that time, we had momentum, we were retaining the ball better, they were getting frustrated, the crowd was getting frustrated. So I was really happy with everything the guys had done to that point. But when you play against world-class players, you make a mistake and you get punished. And unfortunately, we learned the hard way.
Before we go around the room again, we'll go online. Chris Biederman, Sacramento Bee.
Yeah, that's for Roro. I understand this is obviously still fresh, but when you look back at this in the future, what do you think you're going to remember about this run you guys went on?
That we were close, but at the end of the day, we have to be proud of ourselves. You know, we made history. We did things that no one thought we could do, or put ourselves in a situation to play a final. You know, that's something that everyone should hold on to. Not everyone gets to play finals, and you know, you always want to win finals and win rivalry games, but I'll remember this because, you know, hopefully, and I know this team's very capable of winning the USL championship, so you know, we're going to work super hard, extremely hard to get there. And if that's the case one day, then, you know, just remember this moment, how we feel right now, and learn from it. And hopefully, you know, we're able to lift the cup in our own league.
Charles Beam.
Hi, this question is for both of you. With the way the game played out with tired legs later on, would you have preferred to have the weekend off? Do you think that both your league and the organizers of this tournament have done enough to help teams like you guys who are coming from lower divisions, who maybe don't have the same resources as the MLS teams?
We play lower level football. We were a second division team, and that was our schedule. And we looked at it, and we didn't. If you look at the team on Saturday and you look at the team now, Only Lee Desmond played for 25 minutes. So that's our schedule. That's a hurdle we had to overcome. And the guys overcame it, and the guys gave everything out there tonight. So it is what it is. That's what we have to deal with. So, yeah, we'll just leave it there.
Yeah, I mean, it's not an excuse. We did what we could. You know, luckily we have a group of 24 players that could all come in and play and get a chance to compete and win games. You know, we were rested. There's no excuse. Yeah.
Kevin Wynn.
Hey, gentlemen. I know it was really disappointing how it ended up playing out, but a lot of people saw you guys ball out for the first time today. From your perspective, what do you think you guys showed the nation today in terms of the quality you brought and how you competed?
I think the guys gave a fantastic representation of themselves individually and as us as a group collectively, and also gave a great representation of Division II soccer, the USL Championship. They should be proud of the performance they put out there, and hopefully it highlights there are good players in the second division. There are good players that have the potential to move on and play on a stage like they played on tonight. If you take the time to look.
Andrew Jones.
Thank you, Coach. Congratulations on a great run for you, and a run that everyone still will remember as being a timeless run for a USL side. I wanted to ask you, though, in terms of, do you feel the behavior from Orlando City over the last day and then the tension in the moment with Coach Pereira, do you feel that they were at least gracious guests towards you, or are you disappointed in how they conducted themselves over the course of the past 2 days?
That's for other people to decide and for other people to talk about. Congratulations to Oscar and the organization for winning the Open Cup. That's what they did. They beat us tonight. And they've won the Open Cup, so congratulations to those guys, and yeah, I wish them all the best.